panic about, but we need to be careful in our lifestyle. We need to be careful not to just go around just like that. We have to maintain social distance properly. We'll have to maintain our sanitization measures that has been already, you know, told so many times. We have to put it into a lifestyle. That is more important. We have to live with this corona. So this is how it is going to be.
Sir, kati wata statement, this is especially Tripura statement. Army le garda pani parameter le garda pani phailieko cha. So jun chha hamro ma cha army parameter cha. So waha le cha aundakheri kun chha protocol follow garcha jun chha state le
waha ko lagi yesto cha. Waha ko lagi because they fall under the purview of the home ministry. So what they do is in Salugara, there is a what you call the cantonment there. First they come whichever part of India they come, they keep these army personnel there under quarantine.
Okay.
And only after that, if they follow the quarantine rules, they are given a pass. Mm-hmm. So that is what is happening presently.
Okay.
And basically, and they have their dedicated, like in living also, they have a dedicated hospital where they'll be taken care of if there is any symptom. And yes, we are open, why not? Because if anybody suffers any kind of flu-like symptoms or flu-like illness, or whatsoever, they can be taken care of here also. So I think that cause of worry is not there because they have basically maintained that quarantine now.
Yes,
so Sikkim has become a model of COVID for the long time. So now the case is rising like anything. So, so is the medic team enough to handle the situation in the health department?
Certainly. Because you see, it the preparation, the alertness, the kind of the workforce that we need is already structured at different levels. We have the structure at the frontline level, we have the structure at the screening level, we have the structure at the quarantine level, we have definite trained, well-oriented and experienced manpower at the isolation ward. So it's all now all structured here. So we have no problem. We don't have thousands of cases because, and that is not also going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
So it is under our control and there is not going to be that much, you know, panic.
Okay. Sir, there is a public feedback is going on that people coming from red zones should be kept in red zone quarantine, similar like
demarcation of zones.
No. Along that line only, what we have done this time around is people coming from Mumbai, they are put into a facility quarantine, which is, that is how you got these cases, no, positive. Because they were all segregated. Mumbai, all coming from Mumbai, they were kept into those facility centers. That's why it was easy for us. No, we didn't mix them up. So that is what it is.
Already good news.
Yeah. And in fact, if you call about red zone, now everywhere it is red zone.
Mm.
We are in red zone.
Yes, sir.
So there is no cause to distinct. But for our own operational feasibility, for our own operational this thing, we have segregated them in groups. So that Mumbai, people coming from Mumbai, they were kept in separate facility quarantine. And then, you know, as you remember, the first case which became positive, Ravangla, what we did is that we isolated those people at one facility quarantine center, whereby they are not exposed to others. And eventually you saw that the active case also became negative and now he's gone home. So kudos to our health worker once more.
Sir, two more questions. Okay, sir, firstly, the COVID section of the hospital is likely to be shifted.
Yeah.
How is that going to be planned in the future?
No, this is what it is. There is one hospital which is being built here. It's almost at the verge of completion. So that is a basically infectious disease hospital. So whereby we will be dedicating one or two floors, okay, for the coronavirus patients. So that way the corona positive patients and all, they can be shifted to that place so that there is no mixing of patients and people in this section of the hospital so that this hospital can run smoothly.
So when is it likely to happen? That
so that is going to happen because there is a, they are doing the work.
It's a civil work that's carrying
civil,
on, eh?
Civil.
Sir, another question. See, with regards to Manipal being used as a referral hospital right now and the understanding between STNM, how is it working out right now and why was the decision so important? And
no, that decision was very important because there was a likely chance. Now it is all the more important now.
Mm-hmm.
There are so many people have become positive and all, they're coming around.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a high chance because in the same building, there can be a chance of intermixing of people rather than social distancing. There will be social mixing. So that will jeopardize our whole system. The whole idea will be defeated. The idea of isolating the people, the idea of tracing tracking and treatment. Mm-hmm. Tracing, tracking and treatment becomes only possible when you don't mix these people with other people.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we were bound to take this kind of decision.
Mm-hmm.
But it is a very temporary one.
Mm-hmm.
Even though we have just done what MOU only for 2 months,
mm-hmm.
so I think even before that also, mm-hmm. before 2 months only, we'll be able to open up that our infectious disease hospital,
mm-hmm.
so which will serve our primary purpose,
mm-hmm.
and business as usual, mm-hmm. the services as usual, mm-hmm. for the SDNM will be resumed.
Sir, it's not a concern of Manipal losing its private hospital tag and becoming a referral hospital as per the 1992 agreement, right, sir?
Different issue. Mm-hmm. This is a very temporary arrangement, I told you, because mm-hmm. we have to go by our available resources.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot think of other resources. We cannot mm-hmm. think of anything else right
mm-hmm.
now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So the available resource nearest to us is that.
Mm-hmm.
And they have been serving our people only.
Mm-hmm.
They're not serving from people from outside.
Mm-hmm.
So naturally they have to take this burden also.
And how abiding is Manipal and its management with regards to the concern, sir?
They have to avoid.
Mm-hmm.
They have to avoid by that.
Mm-hmm.
And they are willing, but it's not about forceful thing.
Mm-hmm.
They are happily avoiding
mm-hmm.
it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that we are forcing something and doing it, no.
Mm-hmm.
They themselves willingly came up
mm-hmm.
and they talked about it.
Mm-hmm.
We are, sir, here to contribute in whatever possible ways we can.
Mm-hmm.
And that is how we
okay. Sir, given your expertise as a doctor and two of the senior most doctors going in a time of crisis, Dr. Suresh Rasaili and Dr. Ruth Johnson, mm-hmm. pediatrics and medicine, your words on them being taking charge of the whole 50 cases right now or 60 cases, Ali Ribandi, Mr. Sir, about that also.
No, that is again good because you have more experienced doctors, so you can imagine
mm-hmm.
the results will be always, you can expect better results from them.
Mm-hmm.
And as because it's a question of dedication.
Mm-hmm.
It's a question of we are going to do it. We're going
mm-hmm.
to pull it off.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we are not going to let any casualty happen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
whatever possible from our side, whatever possible from our experience,
mm-hmm.
whatever possible from our resources.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
So that is why I told you we are prepared,
mm-hmm.
and we are doing in a phased manner,
yes, sir.
And we are prepared for anything. You know,
mm-hmm.
so because our numbers are not that high.
Mm-hmm.
We would have been worried if the number was huge, high,
yes,
thousands
sir.
Of people. Then that would have been some cause of worry.
Mm-hmm.
But now, you know, the numbers are not that high, so and we are prepared and in a phased manner it can be dealt with,
yes, sir.
Very easily.
Sir, if concerns go bleak from here on with regards to Sikkim, would we see you donning a different uniform and actually coming to the hospital for any sort of...
No, definitely, we do. I, as a doctor, have taken a Hippocratic oath.
Yes, sir.
Certainly I do, I'm a professional.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to chip in.
Mm-hmm.
It's like battle, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's like battle in many
mm-hmm.
countries.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even the civilians, they go with gun
mm-hmm.
and they fight.
Mm-hmm.
So if required, yes, we'll have to do it.
Definitely, sir.
Yes?
Right, sir.
So don't
thank you
think
so much, sir.
So much of pressure on lab technicians, especially for sampling.
No, that is already there. Because that is why they are doing extraordinary. That way, kudos to them. That's
yeah.
why I'm telling.
Yeah.
There was so much pressure. You can imagine, you know, our samples were refused. You can imagine because their samples are piled up to such an extent that they couldn't cope up with the
right.
situation.
Yeah.
So when they couldn't cope up with the situation, they simply refused our sample. So we had to take the back beating.
Mm.
But our people raised to the occasion
mm.
and they're doing works for, you know, hours together.
Yeah,
they're not worried about
extra.
And they're not worried about shift and all.
Mm.
I'm telling you, even I am sitting with my phone, getting all the updates right in the middle of the night.
Mm-hmm.
They're updating me.
Sir,
this is happening, that is happening. So that shows the kind of dedication and the kind of, you know, the pressure under which they are working. And it's wonderful. It's wonderful. It's our moral responsibility, not only me as a health minister, but as from the part of all Sikkimese people, we should give kudos to them.
Right.
We should encourage them. These are our ultimate warriors who are doing wonderful job for us. And because of them only, we can track the people, trace the people, and definitely treat them. And the results you saw today, that, you know, happily, two happy faces, they went back home for home quarantine.
Sir. Thank you very much.